This week, I'll show you why you need a fast lens for astrophotography. Astrophotography is a specialty in photography that you can get into, and nowadays you can get into it relatively cheaply. If you have a kit lens at f4 or f5.6, you'll need to get some glass that will let in more light. Depending on your budget, you can go for something like the Batis 25mm. If you don't have the money for that, you can get the cheaper Samyang 24mm. It really helps and will give you much better results if you do get a fast lens. I'll show you the differences between the kit lens and the faster primed lenses, and then the benefits of these speciality lenses. I'll take it that you know how to shoot the stars. If not, click on the eye in the corner to one of my other videos on how to shoot the stars. Basically, you have to keep the camera rock steady on a good tripod and keep the shutter open for long enough to get the light from the stars into the camera, but not too long so that the stars start to streak. You'll need a remote shutter release or have the drive mode set to self timer. Now with the 24-70mm, it is a good all-around lens, but it doesn't specialize in anything in particular. For astrophotography, you can get good images with it, but they'll tend to be noisy because you have to bump the ISO up. Also, if you shoot with a Sony camera, the lens will be fly-by-wire, so the focusing will be tricky to get. And this is why manual lenses are so good. You can focus and set the aperture before even turning the camera on, and then you can check to make sure the focus is in the same place just by shining a torch on it. My 14mm and 24mm Samyang are both Canon mounts, and I have them on adapters. I've tested both of these lenses in the daytime to find the infinity focus point, and it is good to do this as sometimes the quality control at Samyang isn't that great. My 14mm has an infinity point just off the marked one, so I know that when I have this lens in this point, the stars will be in focus. The 24mm Samyang also has a much wider aperture, so it lets in so much more light. If you have a kit lens, you really have to bump up the ISO to get the shutter speed where you want it to get a well-exposed image, and this will mean a noisy image. Even though editing programs are getting better and noise reduction techniques are developing, you'll still get a kind of painterly looking image when you push the noise reduction a little bit too much. With the Samyang 24mm at f1.4, it will let in 3 more stops of light if your kit lens is at f4. So looking at the images side by side, you can see why it's necessary to have a speciality lens for astrophotography. At £450 in the UK or $429 in the US, this just about comes into the budget range of lenses, especially considering an L-series Canon equivalent is $1,549. And that's about it. I have a few different speciality lenses just for astrophotography. They stay in the bag until it gets dark. The light gathering ability of these lenses is spectacular. And if you want to get some good astro shots, you need to consider these lenses. They will let in so much more light. They'll make it easier for you to focus, and this will give you more time to take photographs and less time to faff around with your kit. To see what else I have in my bag, click on the eye in the corner. This will take you to a video of how to shoot the stars. As always, if you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. And for weekly tutorials, hints and tips on photography and videography, subscribe and turn on notifications. I'll see you in the next one.